Hello students, welcome to the e-learning platform presented by Mechanical Engineering Department of Dr. Bapuji Saloke Institute of Engineering and Technology, Kolhapur. The learning objective for today's session are number 1, study the different stages of combustion in SI and CI engine. While the combustion of air fuel mixture or air only air or air fuel, there are different stages in which combustion takes place. We are going to study the different stages of combustion in both SI and CI engine. Next, study of different types of pollutant and types of catalytic converter. Pollutant are the gases coming out of a vehicle which can be harmless or harmful. We are going to study the different types of pollutants, basically the most harmful, and the types of catalytic converter. A catalytic converter is a type of a muffler or a silencer that is used to reduce the emissions coming out from an IC engine powered vehicle. We are going to learn these objectives in our today's session. Starting with combustion in SI engine. In SI engine, air fuel mixture from carburetor is introduced into the intake valve of an cylinder during the suction stroke, and it is compressed to the compression ratio of 6:10, and the mixture is ignited just before the end of the compression stroke by means of an electric spark. A turbulent flame develops following the ignition and propagates through the mixture of fuel and air. The combustion in SI engine is divided into 3 stages as shown in figure. The first stage is the stage 1, called as ignition lag or preparation phase. First stage, called ignition lag, related with growth and development of propagating flame. This is chemical process, depends upon the temperature and pressure, the nature of the fuel and proportion of the exhaust gases remaining inside the cylinder. At the end of the first stage, there is increase in pressure as shown in the figure below. The first stage starts at point A and increases till point B. It can be detected on the indicated diagram given aside. It is the point where the line of combustion departs from the compression line. The start of first stage is the ignition of charge. From this, the combustion spreads to develop an envelope of mixture immediately surrounding it. The second is the propagation of flame. Second stage is propagation of flame. It is a simple process, simple and mechanical process. During second stage, the flame spreads throughout the combustion chamber at constant velocity. The first measurable sudden pressure and temperature rise can be seen again in indicator diagram from point B to C, that is the point where the line of combustion departs from line of compression. Heat transfer to the wall is as less part of burning mixture come in contact with the wall. The release heat depend upon the turbulence intensity and the reaction rate of the charge, that is the air fuel mixture. And the third and last stage is afterburning. Afterburning is the end of second stage. That means completion of flame traveling into the cylinder, but it does not result in complete heat release. Third stage is the instant at which the pressure reach on indicator diagram denoted by the point C. The velocity of the flame decreases, so combustion rate decreases due to surface of the flame front becoming smaller and reduction in turbulence, since the expansion stroke starts before this stage. These are the stages in combustion in SI engine. Next is the combustion in CI engine. In CI engine, the fuel is sprinkled and the air is sucked by the engine. The combustion in CI engine is considered into four stages as shown in figure aside. 1, 2, 3, 4 represents the four stages. The first stage is the same or is known as ignition delay period. During this period, the fuel has already been sucked inside the cylinder, but it has not been ignited. The period from start of injection to the point where curve separates from pure air compression. The point that is start of injection, or the first stage, is from start of injection to the start of combustion as shown by 1 in the given figure aside. Second stage is rapid or uncontrolled combustion. In the second stage, the rapid pressure rise due to the delay period of the fluid droplet have a time to spread over a wide area and fresh air around them. The period is counted from end of delay period to point of maximum pressure. About 1/3 of heat is evolved during this process. This process is uncontrollable process as the pressure is still rising. As shown in figure, the point 2 or the distance between the two lines is the rapid combustion period. Third is the controlled combustion. The temperature and the pressure in the second state is quite high. Hence, droplet of fuel injected in second stage start to burn in the third stage faster with reduced ignition delay as soon as they find the necessary oxygen, and further pressure rise is controlled by again the injection rate. This can be shown by the line 3 and it can be seen in the indicator diagram. And the last is fourth, that is after burning. This stage may not be present in all cases because of poor distribution of fuel particles. Combustion continues during the part of remainder of expansion stroke. This is called after burning. After burning cannot be remain in all vehicles because the exhaust stroke will throw the residual gases out. This is the process or stages in combustion in CI engine. The next is polluting emissions in IC engine. Vehicle emissions control is the study of pollutants containing in exhaust emission gases and try to reduce its negative effect on public health and natural environment. Petrol consists of mixture of various hydrocarbons, and if we could get the perfect combustion, then the exhaust would only consist of the carbon dioxide and water vapor plus air which did not enter the combustion process. However, for several reasons, the combustion is incomplete and hence we get carbon monoxide, which is a deadly poisonous gas, and unburnt hydrocarbons in exhaust. Hydrocarbons play an active part in the formation of the smoke. The first polluting emission is hydrocarbons in SI engine and CI engine. The hydrocarbons are formed in SI engine by incomplete combustion of fuel, and complete misfire occurs when combustion quality is poor. Also by evaporative losses from fuel tank, fuel line and carburetor. The major cause of unburnt hydrocarbon in exhaust in the quenching of flame at wall as it approaches a relative cool metal surface. The hydrocarbon are formed in CI engine as the CI engine operates with an overall fuel lean equivalence ratio. Therefore, they emit 1/5 of the hydrocarbon compared with SI engine. The major cause of hydrocarbon emission in CI engine are the diesel fuel component contains higher molecular weight on average than the SI engine, resulting in higher boiling and condensation temperature. Hydrocarbon particles condense on the surface of the solid carbon generated during the combustion. Air fuel mixture is heterogeneous. It causes local spot of rich and lean mixture. This causes the mixture to evaporate, causing the hydrocarbons in CI engine. Next is carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxides are a result of cold flame reaction and richer fuel ratio in combustion chamber with local deficiency of oxygen, which causes incomplete combustion creates the carbon monoxide. It is also known as CO. The SI engine operates close to the stoichiometric ratio of a fuel at a part load and operates rich at full load. Under this condition, CO emissions are significant, whereas CI engine operate well on lean stoichiometric ratio and produce less CO emission. CO is colorless, odorless and a tasteless gas. Generally, it is 1 to 2% or 200 gram per kg of fuel. Third is the most important, nitrogen oxide, also known as NOx. The oxides of nitrogen are formed within the combustion chamber due to the dissociation of molecular oxygen and nitrogen at peak combustion temperature and persist during expansion and exhaust in non-equilibrium amount. The amount of NOx depends upon the concentration of atomic oxygen and nitrogen and also the temperature. NOx is about 100 to 1000 ppm particle per minute or 10 gram per kg of fuel. High temperature with large amount of air available produce considerable amount of oxides of nitrogen. In SI engine, if ignition spark is advanced, the cylinder temperature will increase and more NOx will be produced. And in CI engine, with divided combustion chamber and indirect injection tends to generate higher level of NOx. And the last is the particulates. Particulates are lead, organic particulates including soot and sulfate. Fuel contains sulfur which oxidizes with engine cylinder to form SO2. SO2 is oxidized to SO3, which combine with water to form sulfuric acid. Leaded fuel emit lead compounds. Soot, emulsion, black smoke is a result of a rich mixture. In CI engine, carbonous material, soot, with some organic compounds have been absorbed. Most particulates generate due to the incomplete combustion of the fuel. The remaining gases other than hydrocarbon, carbon monoxide and particulates and nitrogen are known as particulates. The particulates, if black smoke is visible, the carbon particle is suspended and depend upon the air fuel ratio and increases with the load as the availability of the air. And if blue white smoke is available, it is due to the liquid droplet of the lubricating oil from internal leakage of oil in the engine. The to stop this or the effect of these pollutants on the environment causes the harmful different problems, such as the soot particles are very smaller in size and it can be absorbed by the human lungs. So this can be an active carrier of cancer producing substances. For carbon monoxide, it causes headache, nausea and breathing problem, whereas for hydrocarbon it causes mucous membrane. Hydrocarbon can also cause the lung and throat irritation. And for nitrogen oxide, the poisonous gas can destroy the lung tissue. If distributed into atmosphere, eventually forms nitric acid, which is heavily contributing towards the acid rain. In today's session, we had studied the combustion in SI engine and CI engine, stages of combustion in SI engine and CI engine, the pollutants affecting the environment and different types of pollutant. We were also going to study the catalytic converter, which we are going to study in further coming session.